where I have to describe and sketch each type of triangle. We'll take a look at a scalene triangle, isosceles triangle, right triangle, equilateral triangle, obtuse triangle, and acute triangle. So first, a scalene triangle is a triangle that has three sides of different length. And here's a picture of a scalene triangle. Again, each side of this triangle has a different length. And often we'll use tick marks to communicate whether sides have the same or different lengths. So for example here, because all three sides have a different length, we could use one tick mark here, two tick marks here, and three tick marks here. Because each side has a different number of tick marks, we know they have a different length. If they had the same number of tick marks, this would indicate they have the same length. Next, an isosceles triangle is a triangle that has two sides of the same length. So here's a picture of an isosceles triangle. This side and this side have the same length. So using tick marks, if we put one tick mark here, we would also put one tick mark here, indicating these two sides have the same length. And because this third side can have a different length, we can use two tick marks to indicate this side does not have to be the same length as the other two to be an isosceles triangle. Next, we have a right triangle. A right triangle is a triangle that has a 90 degree or right angle. So here's a picture of a right triangle. Notice this interior angle of the triangle measures 90 degrees or is a right angle, which is why this is a right triangle. And we'll often see a little square here to indicate this angle measures 90 degrees or is a right angle. Next, we have an equilateral triangle. An equilateral triangle is a triangle that has three sides of the same length. So this is an equilateral triangle because the three sides have the same length, which we can indicate using one tick mark on each side, indicating they all have the same length. Another property of an equilateral triangle is that all the interior angles have a measure of 60 degrees. Next, we have an obtuse triangle. An obtuse triangle is a triangle that has an angle greater than 90 degrees. So notice in this triangle, this angle here is an obtuse angle, meaning it measures more than 90 degrees and less than 180, which is the reason why this is an obtuse triangle. And then finally, we have an acute triangle. An acute triangle is a triangle that has all three angles of less than 90 degrees. So here's a picture of an acute triangle, again, because each interior angle has a measure that's less than 90 degrees. The last thing to mention here is that it is possible for one triangle to have more than one description. As an example, notice how this is an acute triangle because each angle measures less than 90 degrees. But if we go back and take a look at an equilateral triangle, notice each of these angles are also less than 90 degrees. So all equilateral triangles are also acute triangles. As another example, notice how here we have a right triangle because this triangle has a 90 degree angle. So it is possible for a right triangle to also be a scalene triangle if the right triangle has three sides of different length. So it is important to recognize that a single triangle can be classified as more than one type of triangle. I hope you found this review helpful.